Patrick was born 3 months early to a 15-year-old single mother. He required intubation and ventilation for over 6 weeks. He was diagnosed with bronchopulmonary dysplasia, apnea, bradycardia, hyperbilirubinemia, hypoglycemia, and a left intracranial hemorrhage. What this amounts to is the fact that Patrick was a sick little baby with a very bleak prognosis. He spent his first 3 months and his first 3 birthdays in the neonatal intensive care unit. One of Patrick's first doctors told his adoptive parents that he would never walk, never talk, and never feed himself.
We got Patrick when he was 90 days old. He was very fragile and sickly. Shortly after we got him, our pediatricians wanted us to take him to see a neurologist. The neurologist did her hourly exam and said he had a neurological disorder, which I didn't think sounded too bad. And she handed me a packet upside down as we were walking out the door. And with my arms full of breathing machines, baby, and diaper bag, I got on the elevator and turned the envelope over, and it said, "Learning how to handle the young infant with cerebral palsy." And I fell apart and was absolutely devastated. At another visit with the same doctor, she informed us that he would probably never walk, talk, sit, probably would never feed himself, and the maximum he would ever do is be able to hold his head in a wheelchair. And I guess because I'm stubborn, I wasn't ready to accept that diagnosis for him. So we got him involved into therapy, and we were determined to work with the therapist to better Patrick's life.
When I first came to Children's Therapy Center, I was bad, and then they helped me. So yeah, I'm very grateful for that.
I was Patrick's first physical therapist. I started seeing him when he was approximately 3 or 4 months old. That's when he was discharged from the hospital. He was a very small, fragile little baby who had a lot of complications from his prematurity. In addition to Patrick seeing me to help him with his motor skills, he had other therapists who worked with him to help him with his eating and communication skills.
It's very common for premature babies to have difficulty eating and also communicating. Through their work with a speech and language therapist, they learn to coordinate their tongue, they learn to coordinate their oral muscles, cheeks, and lips, and from there move into using those sounds to get things. One gift I think we're able to give families is an understanding and appreciation of the things their children are able to do. Many of the families arrive with lots of information about what their children cannot do, what the deficits are, what the problems are, what the issues are, what the delays are, and they often have lost sight of the wonderful qualities that their children have and the wonderful accomplishments that their children have made. And our job really is not only to work with the child, but to work with the child and then give that information to the parents for them to follow through. And without that follow through, it flat out doesn't work.
They were also there to pick us up when there were disappointments, and they comforted us and encouraged us that, you know, this is another obstacle that we'll have to get over, but we'll get over it.
I remember when Patrick was turning 3 and the school district said he needed to be able to walk up the bus steps by himself or he would have to be in a wheelchair. Well, he had just started walking and there was no way I wanted that kid in a wheelchair, so we spent weeks practicing climbing stairs until he was accomplished so he didn't have to have his wheelchair to go to school on the school bus.
Patrick enjoyed a lot of the things that he did at therapy, but one of his favorite things is riding the horse with Sue.
When Patrick was about 3 years old, he started in our hippotherapy program. Hippotherapy program is where we use a walking horse or pony to exercise the child, primarily working their trunk and hip girdle. A walking pony has a constant forward, back, side to side, and rotational movement that goes up through the rider that they have to absorb in their trunk in order to stay on.
Do you know why I think they enjoy that? They really don't think they're working. And they're enjoying being on the horse and don't realize they're getting the workout. Another part of Patrick's therapy that made a big difference was his orthotics.
About 70 to 80% of the children at CTC wear some kind of dynamic orthotics. These braces are very thin and flexible. They are very comfortable for the children to wear. They are custom molded precisely to each child to get optimal support and control for their feet and ankles, and that assists the whole body to move more easily. Patrick has worn these kind of braces since he was about 2 years old, and it's allowed him to participate in sports and do the kinds of things that every child does.
I play baseball, I play soccer, and I play basketball. I wanted to get on football, but that's well, my mom wouldn't let me.
It's hard to imagine where Patrick would be today if he had not received the early interventions that he got when he was younger. We have known other children that didn't get the opportunities to have the early therapy, and those first 3 years are the most crucial years to get as much therapy as you can get in to benefit the child, to give them the ability to accomplish what they can accomplish.
Through the years, Patrick and his family have taken advantage of nearly all the services CTC offers. In addition to physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, feeding therapy, orthotics, hippotherapy, and early education playgroups, Patrick is currently building his strength and endurance in our aquatic therapy program.
Going to Children's Therapy Center has helped me it's getting me stronger and helping my balance good, and just been great for me.
When Patrick puts his mind to something, it's something that he will succeed in. He's been active in Boy Scouts, a lot of hard work, years of merit badges, but he has finally accomplished the highest award in Boy Scouts, which is being an Eagle Boy Scout.
That even with his, you know, obvious weakness on one of his, you know, on one side, he's still able to play basketball just as well as anybody else, and he holds his own in the troop when we do sports. So I think he's got a lot of guts to try something new, and he strives to be real good at it.
If you really want to accomplish anything, it doesn't matter what disabilities you have, you just have to go for it and just do the best you can.
He has a drive and excitement for life that inspires me, which is why I nominated him for the to run in the torch. He overcomes that which might hold someone else back, and I think that's what makes him so special.
When I first got my torch lit, first I just walked because it was such an emotional feeling and my body can't react to that, and then I started running. I felt very proud and very proud, like, to run the torch and know that I did it.
When I think back of all the therapy, all the surgeries, all the illnesses, I could not believe that this was the same boy that 15 years before that was on life support, and they told me he would never walk, never run, or do anything.
Hey, Patrick, what do you think about that diagnosis?
I think I showed you.
Booker T. Washington once said, Success is not measured by the heights one attains, but by the obstacles one overcomes in its attainment. With your generous support, CTC will be able to continue to help children like Patrick overcome their obstacles.